Today we're talking about explosive volcano science and what causes volcanic eruptions. First of all, the Earth's crust is broken up into 17 separate tectonic plates that float on top of the Earth's mantle, which is a sea of searing hot liquid rock, otherwise known as magma, 21 miles or so below the Earth's surface. Volcanoes are formed when this crust ruptures and the magma rises to the surface. This usually happens when one tectonic plate meets another. The volcano forms when the hot magma is pushed towards the surface, building up an immense amount of pressure over thousands, if not millions, of years, thanks to the gradual movement of the Earth's mantle. Eventually, the pressure becomes so great that the volcano itself bursts, like a shaken-up Coke can, with all that pressure being expelled into the air, and with it goes molten lava, volcanic ash, and noxious gases. There are several different kinds of volcanic eruptions. Some of them are fairly tame, like Hawaiian eruptions, where lava constantly flows from vents in the rock, like a peaceful, searingly hot fountain. Others, like Plinian eruptions, are far more violent. The forces created when they erupt are strong enough to produce earthquakes and tsunamis, as they expel hundreds of tons of volcanic rock, or pumice stones, into the air to rain down on surrounding areas. Plinian eruptions also produced pyroclastic surges, which are clouds of hot gas and ash that cascade down the mountainside at speeds of up to 300 miles an hour. One of the biggest eruptions was the eruption of Krakatoa in 1883, which threw so much ash into the air that it blocked out the sun across much of the world, leading to wintry conditions and failing crops around the world. Another famous example is the eruption of Mount Vesuvius in 79 AD, which buried the Roman town of Pompeii in so much ash that it was perfectly preserved right up until the modern day. The name Plinian actually comes from the Roman explorer Pliny the Elder. There are roughly 1,500 volcanoes on Earth right now, but more are being created all the time, albeit somewhat slowly. The island of Iceland was almost entirely created by volcanoes, with molten rock slowly building up from underwater volcanoes until an island was finally formed. Some of these volcanoes are so large that they're called supervolcanoes. These are so large that when they erupt, they can seriously disrupt the ecosystem of the entire planet. One such supervolcano is located under Yellowstone National Park in the USA, and if it were to ever erupt, it would be over 1,000 times more powerful than the Krakatoa eruption, and could signal an enormous change in the Earth's climate. But Earth doesn't have the trademark on volcanoes, no, no, no. Many planets and moons in the solar system have them as well. In theory, any rocky planet with active geology can develop them. Jupiter's moon Io has over 400 volcanoes, despite being roughly the same size as Delaware. The biggest volcano ever discovered is actually on Mars, and it's called Olympus Mons. It's so large that it's three times the height of Mount Everest, and roughly the same size as France. Brian Greene once said, "Science is a process that takes us from confusion to understanding." And we couldn't agree more, as science has made almost everything simple for everyone. But there are a few things that have no explanation whatsoever. Welcome to YouCurious, and here are 10 things that science has yet to explain. The placebo effect. You all know that when we get ill, we take medicine. When scientists are testing a medicine, they'll often give some of their patients what's called a placebo, which is a substitute for actual medicine. However, it has been found in the past that some patients have responded just as much to a placebo as they would have to actual medicine. Scientists theorize that this is an example of the power of the mind over the body. Because a person believes they're taking the medicine, they start to feel better. 9. Why magnets have two ends. If you look at any bar magnet, you'll see that they have both a north and a south pole. If you cut that bar magnet into lots of tiny, 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 tiny magnets, the same thing would still happen. However, nobody's quite sure why. 8. Why is the sun so hot? Why is the sun's atmosphere so hot? The sun is huge, heavy, and has got a diameter of 1.39 million kilometers, which is 109 times that of Earth. The corona of the sun, its outer atmosphere, reaches a staggering 20 million degrees Celsius. Normally, similar stars to our sun would have a much cooler corona, but as yet, scientists have yet to explain why our sun is so special. 7. Gravity. Sir Isaac Newton even told us about gravity hundreds of years ago when an apple fell on his head. There's no single explanation as to exactly how gravity works. Perhaps the simplest theory for gravity is that it's just a byproduct of all the other natural forces in the universe acting together. 6. Dreams. Science still can't actually explain why human beings dream. Some people believe that dreaming is a way for our mind to filter and process information. Science has yet to explain what dreams mean either. Some people believe that dreams contain hidden messages or meanings, but as yet there's no evidence to support this theory. 5. Where are all the mammoths? Millions of years ago, dinosaurs roamed the Earth. Even as recently as 10,000 years ago, woolly mammoths were around in the days of early man. But why don't we have any huge mammals anymore? There are several theories to explain their extinction. One is the rise of humanity, which resulted in them being hunted to extinction. Another is that climate change occurred at one point in the Earth's past, altering Earth's environment just enough so that survival became impossible for these large beasts. However, the most common line of thought says that they died out due to a number of complex factors acting together. 4. Compass cows. Have you ever watched a cow eat? They stand with their heads lowered to the ground, always chewing on their grass, and always facing either north or south. It's a weird one. 3. Yawning. Yawning is really weird. Common thinking says that we yawn as a reflex because we're not taking in enough oxygen. But still, nobody can explain why seeing someone else you're talking about yawning makes us do it.
Yawn.
2. ASMR. ASMR, or Autonomous Sensory Median Response. Studies have shown that people of all ages and backgrounds experience similar sensations through ASMR, and yet they've got no idea why. 1. Complex carbs. Human beings are incredibly complex organisms, right? You and me containing about 20,000 different genes. They help to make us the diverse and wonderfully complex species that we are. However, do you know what's more genetically complicated than you or me? A tomato. That's right, a tomato has 30,000 genes in its makeup. Why? Don't know, actually. Nobody knows, nor can they explain why the humble spud has even more genes, clocking in at 39,000 genes. You'd think that we, as sentient, walking, talking creatures who've built civilizations, would have a few more genes in there to make us work. But it turns out we might not be quite as complicated as we first thought.